quantum computing, I can say that without fear of contradiction. Of course, this is something that we should not be worried in the short run, but long run, of course, you know, we should be worried. However, the brighter side of quantum computing is pretty bright. So, for instance, with machine learning and with tasks that require large data processing speeds, that is where quantum computing can come pretty handy. To do machine learning, you would need large subset of data and you need heavy duty processing speeds. And that is where the quantum computing would really come handy. Cryptography is one field whereby it would be most impacted in terms of large processing speed. The other thing is when you have things like big data analytics, and that is where large processing speeds would of course be very, very important. Because normal digital computers can only exist in one state. So they could exist in zero or one. Whereas quantum computing can have multiple states, zero and one simultaneously. And a lot of people give an example whereby they would say that digital computers, like, you know, when you flip a coin, you either have a head or you either have a tail. So you either have one or zero. Whereas, you know, think of quantum computing as a coin that is continuously spinning, which means that you can have multiple states, right? And you call this as a qubit. And what quantum computing gives you, specifically when we talk about things like entanglement, is if one qubit can represent two states, two qubits would represent four states. When they are coupled together, it would mean that these states could exist simultaneously, which would mean that you could have a very large processing speed. If attackers can get hold of quantum computers prior to the governments and are able to successfully replicate the model, which is highly unlikely and improbable, then of course it could lead to catastrophe. So, you know, things like password cracking and any scenario whereby you require large processing speeds, that is something where we would see the most of its utility in terms of the attack. But of course, there is a lot of research currently being done on the post-quantum area, where researchers are coming up with new algorithms. There is this consensus among the security community that algorithms like AES-256 are resistant against quantum attacks. So in case, you know, if we have quantum computing now and if there's something that is encrypted with AES-256, you know, it won't, you know, the attacker won't be able to get hold of it. However, algorithms like AES-128 are still vulnerable. So where this is going to have the most impact is on asymmetric algorithms. Algorithms like RSA, which rely upon discrete logarithms. Of course, these are the algorithms that would require change. But with that being said, there is a lot of research and going around that area. And I hope that when we get to a stage whereby we would have quantum computers available to the masses, that is where, you know, we would have upgraded to the newer and better standards.